Hello, I'm Sean with TazCam, and today I'm going to show you how to set up and get started with the new TazCam US HR interfaces. Here I have the US 2x2 HR interface, which I'll connect to my computer via USB-C cable. First off, I'll need to install the driver if I want to be able to use this device on my PC. However, if you're using a Mac, the US HR series will be ready to go right out of the box, so there's no need to install a driver. Navigate to the US HR product page at TazCam.com and download the settings panel and driver here. With the US HR driver now installed, we can route our system audio through the interface. This allows me to watch YouTube videos at a much higher audio quality. The same goes for any audio over the internet, as well as music and video streaming apps. In order to set up the Windows system audio with the US HR interface, we'll first need to enter the settings menu. From here, click on System, then Sound. There are drop-down menus for both output and input. We'll select our interface from there, and now sound from the computer is being routed through the interface. Your new US HR interface comes standard with Cubase LE, which is a fantastic DAW to work with. To start recording, we'll need to install that software. Whether you're using a PC or a Mac, the steps are exactly the same. After installing Cubase LE, we'll create a new project. Then click on the Studio tab, then Studio Setup. Click on VST Audio System and select the US HR interface from the drop-down menu. And now your interface is set up with Cubase. Now that all of our software is set up, I'll plug a microphone into the interface and we'll get some mic signal routed through Cubase. I'll create a new channel in Cubase and set the input to input 1. Since I'm using a condenser microphone, after plugging the XLR cable into channel 1, I'll switch the input to mic line and switch on 48 volt phantom power to deliver current to the microphone. After turning the monitor balance knob to input, we'll slowly adjust the input gain on channel 1 until we have a decent level that isn't peaking or overloading. As you can see, audio is now passing into Cubase, and we're ready to go for music creation and recording. In this video, you saw that I used the US 2x2 HR interface, but the same setup goes for any interface in the series. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to click subscribe to be notified of any new videos that we post.